like going off state benefit. You no longer get paid monthly, and so therefore your needs are unmet. But I was able to do one good thing for myself. I saved some amount of money, and that was what helped me through university in the United Kingdom, and then came back in 1999. Financially, yes, it was difficult, but I was able to cope. By and large, it was not too difficult, you know, to adjust, even though I had to undergo several obstacles and so on. The media was...
The British media?
Exactly. They made me look too bad, a typical stereotype, and wanted to know if I would make myself available, you know, for the ICC.
That's International Criminal Court.
That's the International Criminal Court. That was perhaps the most difficult part. I appeared before a 9-member panel. They did 7, actually, ranging from murder, rape, torture, including that, you know, summary execution. Well, I think was the third. They had even extrajudicial killings, then they had assassination, and then disappearance. And then I was acquitted and discharged. But then the press kept attacking, and I had to run, actually.
Did you come home voluntarily, or were you deported by the British?
I came home voluntarily.
Actually. And how has life been since you came back? I know that you've retired to your place here in the east of Freetown, where you have opened this technical vocational training institute to train people in computer software studying and all of that. But it's an empty place. Tell me about this, your post-presidency life.
It's not so much like an empty place. It's online, actually. The thing is, it's its location. It's a depressed area where most of parents are unemployed. The fees are impossible. But what I've been able to do is to see if I can get government involved in terms of funding. Well, that's the problem with projects like these ones. They tend to be unsustainable.
So what does retired head of state Captain Strasser do on a daily basis? Where do you go to if you're not that busy here? What do you do?
If I have some place to go find some food, that's one thing that I do. Life is not a bed of roses. I mean, my experience has been able to teach me, yeah? I don't have a car, but given the traffic situation in the country nowadays, I don't think I would even want one. But for state functions, if State House invites me, they would send a state car down to pick me up.
Do you regret staging a military coup?
Now, if you ask me, I think that was what the country needed at that time. If it wasn't me, I'm damn sure another officer would have done a similar thing.
So no regrets?
Not at all. It was that same military government that was able to build the institutions that actually did build, you know, a democratic state.
You were accused of wanting to perpetuate yourself in power, that you didn't want to hold elections as planned, which was why there was a palace coup that overthrew you. Did you really want to continue as head of state in a civilian capacity?
That I had a council meeting at Cockerill for a council meeting. I went into that meeting without my pistol, because normally I move with my gun. You know, we're all soldiers. I have a feeling that he wanted to kill me that day, and they announced that he has taken over. The number two always thinks that he has to be number one. That was what I put between myself and Captain Musol. Where he was sitting, I would make sure that we all leave our weapons out.
That's Madabio.
That's right. In the meeting, we all have drawers under the high table. He drew his drawer out, and I saw the pistol, actually. And then he wanted to remove it, and then I knocked it off his hand, kicked it aside. There was some violence, and then was able to negotiate a safe exit out. I was escorted to the military helicopter, and then flew to Guinea.
Your family, do you live with a family? I mean, have you got kids, for example? Are you married?
Yeah, I've got a kid who is attending the school that I attended. My brother is dead, my dad is dead, and I lost an uncle.
And your wife?
I'm divorced, actually, after something like 15 years in separation.
How would you like to be remembered by Sierra Leoneans as this former head of state?
I think history would be the judge.